Hey guys, it's Ria and welcome back to my channel. I hope you all are doing well. So in this video, I'm gonna be doing this beautiful fall makeup look, which is like perfect for the fall season that's going on, and it's full of like dark and bold colors. So firstly, I'm just moisturizing my skin and I'm using my Emolane moisturizer. Make sure you do not skip on this step, otherwise your makeup will end up looking dry and patchy, and you can use any moisturizer of your choice. So for foundation, I am using L'Oreal Infallible 24-Hour Foundation in the shade 145, and this is a tad bit light for my skin, but it oxidizes on my skin, so I'm using a shade that's lighter for me. And to blend it all out, I'm using my beauty blender from Ginger by Lifestyle. This is a really great one. Now for concealing, I'm going in with LA Girl Pro Conceal HD in the shade Classic Ivory. This is a highlighting concealer for me. I'm applying it under my eyes, on the bridge of my nose, on my forehead, Cupid's bow, and also on my chin. Since this is a bold glam look, I'm going all out with my concealer. And now I'm blending it with the same beauty blender. And to set all that in place, I'm using PAC HD powder. This is in the variant banana and it's one of the best setting powders out there. I'm using Wet n Wild powder brush to apply it all over my face, and this not only sets your makeup in place, but it also kind of fills in your pores. I don't know how, but it does the job for me, and I just love this translucent powder. I'm using my beauty blender to apply it under my eyes, not baking, just setting my under eyes in place. So I'm just zooming you in, and I'm going in with my Freedom Brow Pomade in the shade Ash Brown, and I'm using PAC 371 brush to fill in my eyebrows. This is one of the best drugstore brow pomades out there. It's sort of a dupe for Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Pomade, and I just love this one. It does the job perfectly for me, and it is so creamy and so pigmented. After filling my brows, I'm just brushing them through to distribute all of the product. And then I'm just zooming you guys even more in, and I'm using my LA Girl Eye Luxe Mesmerizing Eyeshadow Palette in the shade Sensual. This is such a pretty palette. And I'm using my Miniso Eyeshadow Blending Brush, and I'm picking up the darkest color from the palette. Since this is a very bold and glam look, I'm going in with such a dark color, and I'm applying it all over my lid, slowly building it up. And it comes in so many different shades, so you can pick up any color of your choice. I'm also taking the color onto my bottom lash line to balance it all out. And then I'm going in with my Euro Paris 121 brush. This is an angled eyeshadow brush, and I'm picking up the pink color and blending the edges of the plum color that we just applied. For falsies, I'm using Glomio Beauty eyelashes in Starlit. These are my favorite eyelashes currently, and to apply them, I'm using Adrel Lash Grip in Clear. And these eyelashes look so dramatic and so subtle at the same time. And to finish off the eye makeup, I'm using a mascara by Maybelline. This is their Hypercurl mascara, and I'm just trying to blend my natural lashes with the falsies and also applying it to my bottom lashes. Now for my face, I'm using Makeup Revolution Ultra Pro HD Contour Powder, and I'm picking up that shade to bronze my face. I'm using Wet n Wild contour brush for it. I'm only bronzing my cheeks to bring back a little bit of color onto my face, and also taking the bronzer a little bit onto my temples. And now for my blush, I'm using Maybelline Master Blush Palette. This is one of my favorite blush palettes, and I'm picking up the peach color with my PAC 263 blush brush and applying it onto the apples of my cheeks. This is such a pretty color, you guys. It's like suitable for all skin tones, and it blends really well. It's so flattering. I love this blush palette. Now moving on to the game changer, that is highlighter. I'm using Makeup Revolution Pro Illuminate, which is one of my favorite highlighters, and I'm using ProArt PF 14 brush to apply my highlighter. I'm applying it onto my cheekbones, on the bridge of my nose, Cupid's bow, on my forehead, my chin, and also on my brow bone. I absolutely love this highlighter. This is such a game changer. Like, if you're going for a bold look, this is the only highlighter that you need. It's the best drugstore highlighter ever, and it's so affordable. Like, I cannot stop raving about this highlighter. I love it so much. So I'm also applying it onto the inner corners of my eyes just to highlight them. And now moving on to the final part, that is lipstick. I have these two My Glam Buttalicious Matte Lipsticks with me. The first one that I'm going to be using is a very subtle rosy color, and this one is called Rose. This is like a My Lips but better color for me, and it complements the eye makeup so well. I just love how the look turned out to be. Now I'm using the darker lipstick, which is called Possessed, and this one is very similar to the eyeshadow that I applied, but who said you cannot wear bold on bold? I think it looks absolutely flattering. So let me know in the comment section below which lipstick complemented the eye look better and whether or not you like the final look. I just love the eye makeup that's going on. I think it's so bold and so beautiful and perfect for the fall season. Let me know what you think about the makeup look. And yeah, that's all about today's video. This is Riya signing off. Goodbye.